Ladies and gentlemen, people of the internet, the Bitcoin halving event is coming this summer, and in this video I will break down what it is, what to expect, and what it all means for you. But before we get started, if you're new to the channel, welcome. I work full-time in the industry developing blockchain applications for clients, and my passion is making technology easy to understand and accessible for everyone. That said, this channel is all about providing you free educational content, in-depth tech tutorials, and detailed product reviews that will help you build your knowledge, break into new career paths, and to have fun doing it. If that sounds like something that you're into, please do hit that subscribe button and the little bell notification button next to it so you'll get a heads up on all the latest content that comes out on the channel. Thank you in advance, and without further ado, let's hash it out. Another 4 years have passed, and we're quickly approaching the mid-May 2020 timeline for the third Bitcoin halving in Bitcoin's history. But what is the halving? In the Bitcoin protocol, the halving, or the halvening, as the crypto nerds call it online, is a clever mechanism by which the inflation rate of Bitcoin supply is reduced by half on a set cadence of every 210,000 mined blocks, which equates to around 4 years based on the average 10-minute block time. To give a bit of background here, the only way that new Bitcoin is released into circulation up to the hard cap of 21 million total Bitcoins is by mining, or the process of creating new blocks of valid transactions on the blockchain. A miner that successfully appends a new block to the chain is rewarded in Bitcoin for his or her efforts. And currently that reward is 12.5 Bitcoins, which is quite a nice payday. And this all makes sense because miners do quite a bit of work and incur quite a bit of cost to offer the service of securing the network and mining blocks, their effort, basically. This block reward that miners get serves two main functions. One, it incentivizes miners to do the work necessary to validate transactions on the network and to secure the network. And two, the block reward releases Bitcoin into circulation, and that means that inflation, or the total supply increase within a given time period, is quite stable over time. Remember that one of the main reasons Bitcoin was invented is to act as a refuge or response to the reckless inflation policies of central banks during the 2008 financial crisis. So what does this really mean for the halving itself and what we have to expect in 2020? Well, Satoshi Nakamoto, the creator of Bitcoin, was smart and decided that over time, the inflation rate of Bitcoin supply needs to decline over time, meaning Bitcoin should be more deflationary in nature. By design, the scarcity of Bitcoin is what gives it so much value. Scarcity in and of itself is measured mainly by the difficulty of obtaining Bitcoin and the limited supply it has, paired with increasing demand over time. The halving itself is designed to reinforce those characteristics of scarcity within Bitcoin. It's meant to make Bitcoin harder to obtain because less is created at each new block, and it constricts the creation of new Bitcoin supply. So this means that in around May 15th of 2020, we're going to see the total block reward move from 12.5 Bitcoins down to 6.25 Bitcoins per block mined. This all means more scarcity of Bitcoin in the network. And ultimately, at full scale, this means that the total number of Bitcoins created in the entire network will drop from 1,800 per day to only 900 per day. And that's some serious supply constriction. Now, you're probably thinking, whoa, hold on there, Hishoshi. You said that one of the key reasons the block reward exists is to incentivize miners to secure the network and mine blocks. So isn't this whole thing just cutting their pay in half? Why would they even stay? And that's a great question. And it's one that confounds people in regards to the halving pretty consistently. Now, the answer is this. While the immediate effect of the halving is that the miner's payday gets cut in half relatively, this is also a hidden benefit of the halving event. It's like a big reset button every 4 years or so. Mining in Bitcoin, and any other network for that matter, is voluntary. Miners go where profitability is high, and that's the nature of the business. Throughout the last 6 months or so, there have been miners that have jumped ship and started mining elsewhere in the expectation of this profitability hit because of the halving. And there will likely be a large-scale exodus when the halving actually does take place in May. This means that the total hash rate, or the measure of miners' total computing power on the network, will drop and constitute a mining difficulty adjustment in the Bitcoin network to accommodate that. This was planned for by Satoshi Nakamoto clearly. However, there are many, many miners who will stay put and mine at a loss or just at decreased profitability for two main reasons. One, the purpose of mining is to reinforce the main value driver for Bitcoin's price, and that is scarcity, like we talked about before. Many big Bitcoin miners are sitting on large quantities of Bitcoin, and they believe that the value is going nowhere but up as a result of the halving. They want to keep collecting Bitcoin and keep riding that wave, regardless of profitability in the short term. These miners have also invested in the network in this way, and for that reason, they'll stay. They have Bitcoin, they want to keep getting more Bitcoin and riding that wave up. And two, many Bitcoin miners have specialized hardware that's tailor-made to mine on the Bitcoin network, and they've optimized their entire setup potentially for millions of dollars to make Bitcoin mining extremely efficient for their setup. And for that reason, they'll keep mining as they were and wait for the price level to keep moving up due to the increased level of scarcity. There's a lot of sunk cost in mining for a lot of these miners. So what does this mean for Bitcoin's price? This is, of course, anyone's guess because we can't possibly predict the macroeconomic response to this event. However, we have some historical data from previous Bitcoin halvings to give us an idea of what to expect if trends follow the same trajectory. In November of 2012, the first halving took place and reduced the Bitcoin block reward from 50 Bitcoin per block to 25 Bitcoin per block, and the price at that time was around $12. After the halving, the price trended consistently positively to a peak of over $1,100 over the course of a year after halving, and then trended back down and sideways to prices around $200, $250 until the next halving in July of 2016. At that time, the Bitcoin halving occurred again, and it went down from a Bitcoin block reward of 25 to 12.5, where we are today in April of 2020. You will all probably remember that after that halving, the trend upward took us into 2017, where we had a peak price of around $20,000, and we've seen some big moves up in 2019 since then. Now, the Bitcoin bulls are claiming that all sorts of crazy price numbers are going to result from the halving, and if the trends continue, we'll see 100K in June. And if the historical response to the halving events in 2012 and 2016 are any indicator, we could see some crazy price growth. However, I'm here to tell you that there are no guarantees that this is going to happen. We can never predict what's actually going to happen in the market today. Setting expectations means that this could happen, but what will happen is totally unknown. I'm as bullish as anyone about Bitcoin and I believe in it, but I'm morally obligated to tell you that I can't make promises or bold claims that I can't possibly back up with confidence. I think price is going up, but there's no way to know for sure. There are a variety of reasons for this, and the first is that increased scarcity can drive price upwards if and only if demand for Bitcoin remains static or it increases with the decrease in availability, so increase in scarcity. Because there are more and more people starting to learn about Bitcoin and the barriers to entry for buying Bitcoin are much lower, we could see this happen. And this is the same reason why in 2012 and 2016 we saw this happening with the advent of Coinbase and other services like it. However, it may take longer to achieve that demand growth in 2020 because the instant exponential price growth people claim we'll see might not be there. Secondly, when we do see these big price moves, people are going to sell. And when people sell, especially in large quantities, price starts to go down. And when price starts to go down, this triggers panic selling and price falls further still. Every halving event has seen this happen where it goes up to new highs, or it goes up and then it drops back down and then goes sideways. So this isn't going to be smooth sailing forever. And then three, we've seen that the trends in the halving events are pretty clear. You can see this graph here that shows it. But the conditions that we have today in 2020 are a lot different than the conditions in 2012 and 2016. COVID-19 is in full effect right now, and the period of economic expansion that we've seen since the advent of Bitcoin seems to be, at the present moment, over at this point. Now, will this affect the results of the Bitcoin halving? No one really knows for sure, but that just means that you have to take the previous historical values that have come out of the halvings and the response with a grain of salt. I think you're probably wondering, though, what does this mean for me? Do I have to do anything? And luckily, the answer is pretty simple. No action is required from you at this point. The Bitcoin halving will occur with or without you if you have Bitcoin in your wallet, and you don't have to take any action whatsoever once this halving occurs. The only thing that I ask of you is that you take both sides of the price argument with a grain of salt. Those who say we're going to 100K in June 2020 are guessing just as much as those who say we're going to zero. And please, if you have Bitcoin on an exchange or in an online wallet, a hot wallet, just take control of it and put it on a hardware wallet. Things are crazy right now. You never know what's going to happen, especially with the economic pressure that we're really under right now. Exchanges could fold. Things can happen. You want to control your Bitcoin and your other crypto for that matter. I'll link some cheap options down below if you don't have a wallet, but if you do, please move your Bitcoin to it. As always, folks, I'll link up some other awesome Bitcoin content for you on the screen right here if you have the time. And until next time, folks, cheers.